Hey guys, welcome back to the second puzzle for the series of the Sudoku Grand Prix 7 that was hosted by the Germans and the Dutch authors together. Earlier we had seen the numbered rooms by Richard, and now we are going to have a look at the German Whispers Sudoku. This was created by Jonas Gleim. I hope I got that name right. Apologies if I didn't. Now, the rules of this puzzle are no digit can repeat in any row, column, or a 3x3 box. And additionally, digits along the line, the adjacent digits, that is, along the line, will always have a minimum difference of 5. So, for example, if this was a 2, I cannot have anything less than a 7 here, because the minimum difference of 5 with 2 will be a 7, 8, or 9. And similarly, I'll have a 7, 8, 9 here. So you understand, the adjacent digits will always have a difference of 5. Now what I normally do in these kind of Sudokus is I bifurcate them into highs and lows. High number, then an adjacent low number. And one more thing that we need to keep in mind here is the digit 5 will never be on the line. Because for a difference of 5, I will either require a 0 or a 10 beside the 5, which is just not possible here. Alright? So 5 will never be on the line. And one more thing that we need to notice is the digit 4 has only one digit that satisfies the difference of 5, which is the digit 9. And similarly, the 6 also has only one number with a difference of 5, and that is the digit 1. So what that means is anywhere in the middle of the line along the path, I can never have a 4 and a 6. Now, this is only for a horizontal or a vertical line. For a diagonal line which is going across two cells, I can definitely have them. We'll come to that later. But on this line, if for example I say I have a 4 here, I would require a 9 on either side of it to satisfy the constraint of a minimum difference of 5, which is just not possible. So that is something we need to keep in mind. Using these two tips and keeping them in mind, let's start and see how we can go ahead with this. Alright, so the first thing I notice is the only blank cells which are not covered by a line in column 2 are in row 1 and row 9. So basically what it means is the digit 5 will be in any one of these two, right? And just like for the digit 6 can never be in the path of this, so the 6 will never be in these 5 cells, and I cannot have a 6 here as well, because that would require a 1 in row 8, column 3. Hence, this becomes a pair of 5, 6. Alright? So now we have made some progress. Now, where do we go next? Just like the 6, the 4 also will never be a part of this, right? So the 4 has to be in this. And with a difference of 5, this becomes a 9. Now you understood why I was talking about the diagonal line. That constraint on 4 and 6 would not be possible. So this would be either a 3 or a 4 or a 1, because all these 3 digits have a difference of 5 or greater than with 9. 2 is obviously not. Good so far. So now we have 5 cells here. Now if you remember, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the lows for me, and 6, 7, 8, 9 are the highs. Now the missing digits in this column are 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, which is 3 highs and 2 lows. So obviously the 2 lows will be in the central paths, and these would be your 7, 8, and 9. 7, 8, 9. But by classic rules, this becomes my 9. So that's a 7, 8, and this is a 7. Right, and for 9, 4 cannot be here, so this has to be a 1, 2, and a 3. But now, how do we proceed here? Now, when I look closely at these two, if I have a 3 here, for the digit 3, there are only two possibilities which have a difference of more than 5, which is 8 and 9. Right, but the 9 is already available in the column, and if I have a 3, on at least one side, I'll have a 7. Which does not conform to the rule of a difference of 5. So this has to be a 2, and this becomes my 3. Correct? Because 2 has a difference of 5 or greater with both 7 and 8. Correct? So now, this would be a 1, 3, 4. But I can't have a 4 because I would require a 9 for that 4. So this is a 1, 3. Right? If this is a 1, 3, this would be a 6, 7, and 8. All right, before we proceed here, now with this 3, I cannot have a 7 beside this. This is a 7, 8, this becomes a 7. Now with 7, I can't have a difference of 4 for this, so this has to be a 1. And now I have a 6 and a 8 here. Sorry about that. And this would be again a 1, 3, because I can't have a 4, I can use a 9. Now for a 1, 3, this will be a 6, 7, 9. And this would again be I require a low number with 1 and 2 already there. This has to be a 3 and a 4. Now, again for this row when I look at it, the 5 can only be here, correct? But again, in the middle of the path, I can't have a 4 in this. Neither can I have a 4 here because that would make this a 9. But that's not possible because we already have a 9 in the row. So again, this becomes a pair of 4, 5. And a 4, 5. Correct? 6 cannot be here. It cannot be here because I require a 1, which is not possible. 6 can never be in the middle of the path. So even this is not a 6. So the only place for a 6 is here, which makes this a 1, and this is a 7, 9. Alright? So that means I have a 2, 3, 8, 2, 3, 8, and a 2, 3, 8. Now, assuming if this is a 8, it would make this a low, this would be a high, this would be a low, this would be a high, this would be a low, and this would be another high. But if I have an 8 here as a high, I have covered the high number 6, 7, 8, 9, right? 3 are already present, which means I can't have 2 highs here, right? So I know for sure this has to be an 8. This will be a 2, 3. This will be a 2, 3. This is a low. So 1 and 2 is not, sorry, this will not be a low. Not a 7. 7, 8, and 9. This again has to be a 2, 3, 4. But I can't have a 4 in the middle of the line. Well, I can have a 4 here. The reason being it. 9s will be in two different boxes and not contradicting that. Alright? So here, I cannot have a 6, but I can definitely have a 7 and a 9. And here, I can have a 1, 2, and 3. And this would be. Okay, 6 and 8 is gone, a 7 and a 9 again. So I have 7 and a 9. Right? No. 6 cannot be here. For a 2, 3, I require 7, 8, 9. This again would be 2, 3, 4. I can have a 4 at the edge. Alright, so 2, 3, 4. I can't have a 7 here because 1 is not available. And 7 then can only be available with 2 2s to satisfy the difference of 5. Alright. Alright, so now what? When I look at this 3, 4, I cannot have a 7 here because 7 would require either a 2 or a 1. So this becomes my 9, this becomes a 7, and this becomes a 9 again. And with 7, I know for sure I require a 2 and a 1. I cannot have a 3 or a 4, which would make this 3, and this becomes my 2. Alright, Now for this 3, I cannot have a 7 here. This has to be an 8, 9, 8, 9. With 2, 3 gone, this becomes a 4, which pushes a 9 here and the 8 there. Classic rule 7, 7, this is a 7 and this becomes a 4, 5. Now again, I cannot have a 6 here because that would make this a 1. This 6 is not here, not here. So this becomes my 6 and this is a 3, 4, 5. 5 can never be on the line. Neither can I have a 4 because this I would require a 9 post that. So this has to be a 3. This is a 4, which makes this a 5 and a 4. So this is a 3, 5, 3, 5, and this becomes a 5, which makes this a 4, 6, 4, 6. Classic rules, 9, 9, this is a 9, 9, 9, this becomes a 9. 4, 4, can't be here, this is a 4, 6, and a 4, right? Now with 3, I can only have either an 8 or a 9. 9 is not possible, this is an 8. Which again means this has to be 1, 2, 3, and this will be a 6 and a 7. And I can't have a 3 because the 8 and 9 cannot come here. So this is a 1, 2. So this has to be a 7 and an 8. Right? Now, what next? Is locked here. 2-2 is in the job. Now, these are such classy, beautiful ones. Now, the missing numbers here are 1, 2, and 7, 8. 8 is not possible. 1, 2 form a pair, so this becomes my 7. This is an 8. Alright? This again becomes a 1, 2. This is a 2, 8, 1, 2, 8. Three cannot be here. Three is locked in this. This is not a 3. This becomes my 3. So I require a 5, 6, 5, 6 for the row. But this is a 6. Sorry. This is a 5, this becomes a 6, this becomes a 7. So this becomes a 5, 6 and a 5. 5 cannot be here, so this becomes a 5. And I get a pair of 3, 5 here with a 6 here. And this becomes a 1. So 1 is out, 4 is out, this becomes my 3. The missing here are 1 cannot be in this, so this is a 1, 2 and a 4, which makes this 5 and a 7. So I require a 2, 6 and 8. Alright. But this becomes a 3 because of this, and this is 5, so 3, 3. This is a 3, this becomes a 3, 5, 3. 5, 5, and this becomes a 5, this becomes a 7. I require a 6 and an 8. So this is a 5, this is a 7, this is a 7, 8, 6, 8, 6, 2. So this 2 is out. This becomes a pair of 1, 2. 1, 4, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, oh sorry, 2, 4, not here, this is 7, and an 8. And this was a narrow but a beautiful solving path for this German Whisper Sudoku. Hope you guys were able to crack this during the contest. If not, hope this video was helpful to you. If it was, do like and share it with your friends. And if you have not already subscribed, once again, I'll let you know that please do that because you'll be seeing a series of such awesome puzzles going forward. And if you have any other comment or a feedback for us, do make sure you comment on the videos and let us know how you're finding them or is there something that we need to do to improve the user experience for you. So Till the next time, happy solving.